Hello everybody, welcome back to Embertronics. In our previous video, we have seen how our open, release, read and write functions are being called from the application. In this tutorial, we will see some real-time communication between the application and the device driver. Let's get started. We are going to use these four functions in our device driver. We will see each function one by one. Kmalloc. Kmalloc is a function which allocates the kernel memory. It is similar to the malloc function, but malloc is for user space and kmalloc is for kernel space. We have to include this header file in our driver. This function has two arguments. The first argument size holds the number of bytes that we want to allocate. The second argument is flags. There are many flags available: GFP user, GFP kernel, etc. Please check this website for more information. I have given the link to this website in the description. The next function is kfree, which is used to free the memory which is allocated using the kmalloc. Next, copy from user. This function copies the block of data from the user space to kernel space. This is the destination address, source address, and the number of bytes that need to be copied. At last, this copy to user function is used to copy the data from the kernel space to the user space. This also has the same arguments as the copy from user. Now we will see the code. I have taken the previous video's code as a base and added those functions that we have discussed earlier. In the init function, we are allocating the 1024 bytes using the kmalloc. Then just writing the hello world string as a default string in that memory. In the exit function, we are freeing that memory. In the open and release function, we are not doing anything. Whenever the user reads this device file, this read function will be called. So, we have to provide some data to the user space function. We are using the copy to user function to copy the string data to the user space. When the user writes something to the device file, this write function will be getting called. So, we have to take the data from the user space and store it in our kernel. This copy from user function does this job. That's all about the code. I am using this make file to build our device driver. To test this device driver, we have written a simple application. In the main function, we are opening our device driver's device file. After that, we are asking the user that they want to read or write or exit. If the user wants to write data, we are getting the input from the user and writing that data to our device file using the write function call. If the user wants to read, then we are reading the data from the device file using the read call. If he presses 3 to exit, then we are closing the device file and exiting from there. Now we will see the demo. Build the device driver in both Ubuntu and Raspberry Pi. Load the driver. Now we will build our application. As we have loaded the driver already, we can run the application now. Run the application in Raspberry Pi as well. First, we will read the default data, enter 2. Here, we are getting the hello world string. In Raspberry Pi also, we are getting the same output. Now, we will write our string to the device driver. I am writing Embertronics. Write the same string in Raspberry Pi. Now we will read back the data. See, both the places we are getting the Embotronic string. Now we will move to the BeagleBone demo. Before that, let's exit the application and unload the module. Now we will run the same driver and application in the BeagleBone. First, cross compile the driver. Then copy the driver to the BeagleBone using rsync. We have to install the toolchain to build the application. Install it using this command. I have installed it already. Then using this toolchain, we can build our application. Then copy the application to the BeagleBone. Let's open the serial terminal. See, we have our driver and application. Let me unload the old driver and load the new driver. Then load the application and read the default string. We have got the hello world. Now we will write the data. Let's write Embotronics and read back. See, Embotronics is there. I think now you have some idea about how the application talks to the device driver. In our next video, we will see what is IOCTL and how to use that. Let's exit the application and unload the driver. Please like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you. Talk to you later.